Platinum rating my arse. I'm that one kind of nerdy guy, and today I want to show you my trials and tribulations that I went through in order to get Monster Hunter World working in Ubuntu 18.04. First and foremost, I want to say that I plan on making videos every Friday and Monday, so if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. I'm going to be making new content. If you can't tell, my voice isn't 100%. I just had lost it last week. It's much better than what it was, but it's still not quite there. So, in my channel update, I was saying that I was in kind of a rut last year, where I wasn't really doing anything. I wasn't gaming or anything like that. I got kicked out of that rut about the time that the Steam sale happened. So convenient. During the Steam sale, I picked up three games. One of them was Monster Hunter World. Since the Steam sale, Monster Hunter World is the only game I've been playing. I absolutely love it. I feel like I'm addicted to it. So until about a week ago, all my experience with Monster Hunter World has been in Windows. Like I said, the whole rut thing. I had no idea that Proton and Steam Play had become a thing last year in last August. And once I found that out, I was just like, oh man, what works with it? And I was even shocked to find out that Proton has its own kind of page, just like the WineDB, called ProtonDB. People go on there and they share pretty much how well, or like if they're able to get games running, and if they are, how well those games run. And they base it off of a rating system of like bronze, silver, gold, platinum. I think one of them is borked. After finding this out about Steam Play and Proton, I was just like, I want to play Monster Hunter World in Linux. So that's what I set out to do. I'm going to have my specs, my PC, pop up on the screen just so you can see, oh, that's what that one kind of nerdy guy is rocking. But before I go any further, I need a cup of tea. Good tea. Let's continue. So I looked up the rating of Monster Hunter World on ProtonDB, and you know, I was seeing a bunch of golds, some silvers, like two platinums, which I don't agree with, and I think I saw like one or two borked, if that's the right word. I can't even remember if that's the right word. So after looking this up, I decided, hey, I just updated from 1604 to 1804. Let's just install it and see what happens. So I did that. Error 1. Monster Hunter World loaded up. It seemed like it was going to launch. I went to a black screen. I sat there, waited for maybe a minute, maybe something like that. And then a minute or more, maybe. And then I was met with an error screen. After seeing this error, I was just like, okay, let's just exit out and see if I can do anything about this. The first thing I thought, which shouldn't have been the first thing I thought, was that ProtonDB works. I'm to my knowledge, it works with DXVK, which is Vulkan. So I was thinking, maybe I don't have Vulkan on my system. So I went online, found a website telling me how to install Vulkan. Even though I had already thought I had Vulkan on my system, I could have sworn I put it on a while ago. Anyway, I went to a website, followed the direction center and the terminal, how to install Vulkan and all its dependencies. I got down to the line where you actually hit sudo apt-get install Vulkan, and is that the Vulcan couldn't be found. So, instead of seeing why this was so, I just decided, eh, what the hell, I'm gonna find another reason. So then, I just went back to the game, tried to launch it again, and was met with the same error message. Then I went back on the internet, found that running the game borderless could help. So, I went to where the graphics option any file is, and I'll have the path to that file in the description. And it'll probably show on screen too. I set the screen mode to equal borderless, and I was still unsuccessful. So this time, I went back to the .ini file, and I decided I'm going to try to change it to windowed. So I changed it to windowed, and then on top of that, I switched my resolution from 3840 by 2160 down to 1920 by 1080, just because if I do get this game started, I still want to be able to see my desktop. So this time I started the game, and it finally worked. I was like, yeah, awesome. I was going to be able to play this game now. Error 2. So the game started up. I could hear the music that plays during the opening splash menu screen, but I still couldn't see anything, and I was just waiting for it to show up. After a few minutes, it finally showed up, but I noticed the background on the main menu, everything in it was very, very choppy. I was just like, oh man, come on, this isn't going to work that well. And that was the case. The navigating the menus was very slow. Getting into the game was very slow. It was probably going like maybe 1 frames per second. When I was in the game in Asteria, if I was moving the camera around, it was very, very slow. It's performing horribly. And on top of that, there was these red graphical splotches all over the screen. So I exited the game and I decided I was going to relaunch the game and mess with the graphics options. So I got back into the main menu and I decided maybe these settings are just too much for it to handle. And keep in mind, I'm running this game at 1080, which my computer can handle with no problem at all. So I went to the settings, I switched most of them to a lower state, and I noticed something crazy. If I had switched the image quality to anything else but high, the screen would get filled with graphical errors to the point where I couldn't even see what was going on. I would still be able to see the menus, but that's it. I couldn't see anything else. So with this, I set it to high, and then I decided to go in game, and I would mess with the graphics options in game. And the same exact thing happened. I was messing around. I noticed that if I had it set to anything else but high, I would get these weird graphical issues making so I can't see anything on the screen. And so I would be forced to run it at high. If it was at high, it would only be crawling at like 1 or 5 frames per second. So I went back online, I found that the volume rendering quality setting could have something to do with it. So this time I decided I was going to exit the game, and I was going to switch volume rendering quality to off. So I exited the game, went to the .ini file, changed the property, and saved it. Error 4. So I went to Steam, I clicked play, and I got a Steam error. I tried clicking play again, I got the same Steam error. Did it again, got the same error. This happened 4 times until I actually read what the error was, which I should have to begin with. And it was just Monster Hunter had not stopped running. And this is an issue that I still have to today. Sometimes Monster Hunter World in Steam Play just doesn't shut down all the way. The game continues to run. So to stop this, when you exit the game, just go kill the process. So after changing volume rendering quality and killing the Monster Hunter process, I went back into the game and I was still having the same problems. I was like, damn. So there was one thing that I had thought about doing, and I should have done it to start with. I had thought, I hadn't updated my graphics driver since, like, early 2018. I'm horrendously out of date. So I upgraded my graphics driver in the terminal using this command to upgrade to driver version 4.10. When it finished, I had graphics version 4.10.78. I logged out and logged back in. So this time, when I started the game up, it finally was running smoothly. or I should say smooth enough to play. I went into the game, started an expedition to the Rotten Vale, and it was great. It was finally playable. I ran around the area like an idiot just because I normally play the game with a PS4 controller, so I was not familiar with the mouse and keyboard controls. After this success, I exited the game and I changed the screen mode to borderless, and I also changed my resolution to 3840 by 2160. And on top of that, I also switched down the quality settings to medium because that's how I normally played in Windows. So this time I loaded the game up and I was playing it how I normally do on Windows. I went back into the Rotten Vale, ran around for a little, and then I decided I need to test out multiplayer because that's Monster Hunter, as you know, who plays Monster Hunter alone? I went back to Asteria, answered an SOS request. I started the quest Rumble in the Wasteland, and me and my team, we successfully took down a Diablos and a Black Diablos. This was great. Multiplayer was working just fine. The game was playable. There was only one problem. I was getting horrendous screen tearing. So I exited the game, went to my NVIDIA settings, forced full composite on the display that I was using, and then I went back into the game. Error 5. Once I was in the game, I noticed pretty much right away that the screen tearing was gone. I started a quest, sent out an SOS request, and I started to play with a couple people for a short bit until the game absolutely froze. There was not a single thing I could do. My entire system was just frozen. I had to hard reset my PC. Something that I had forgot to mention was that somewhere along the way I had seen online that for some people, having the GPUs run at max performance makes a difference. But in my case, to me, and I'm still not entirely sure, but this is what I would bet money on. In my case, if I don't have my GPU running at max performance and I have full composite, I'm going to have the game freeze the way it did. So I went back into my NVIDIA settings and I made sure that full composite and max performance were both enabled. So this time I went back into the game. Still no tearing. I started a quest, sent out an SOS. This time, my team had gotten our asses kicked. But nonetheless, no tearing and no freezing. I played a few more quests and I had no problems at all. This was great. It was running perfectly fine. Well, mostly perfect. It's still the only issue that I have is that the game sometimes doesn't close. And you know, I think that's a fair trade-off to have this great game working in Ubuntu like this. All you gotta do is make sure the game is quit running when you're done playing, and you can play an amazing game on Ubuntu 18.04. This is what I'm feeling from the ground to the sea. I'm running out of time with a prime mind. I'm behind, I'm driving the hindsight from a rope in the trees. Quiet, I need my own time. God, it got cold. Ugh.